Hi, welcome back. This is Rakesh Naik. Today we are going to discuss about an application of Q, Josephus problem. This is also known as suicidal circle. But before we start, a small information I'd like to share. In this channel, we produce every video in two different languages, Hindi as well as in English. If you want to watch this video in Hindi, kindly follow the link given in the description. And if you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will get regular updates from this channel. So, let us start. Let us directly come to the objective of the problem. Let us try to understand this. There are n people standing in a circle waiting to be executed. The counting out begins at some point in the circle and proceeds around a circle in a fixed direction. In each step, a certain number of people are skipped and the next person is executed. The elimination process around the circle until only one last person remains, who is given freedom. And the total number of persons are n, the number r which indicates that r minus 1 person to be skipped and the rth person is killed in the circle. The task is to choose the place in the initial circle so that you are the last one to remain so you survive. Let me try to explain it. There is a circle and in the circle there are few people standing. The first person, he is having a sword or a gun and he will be killing his neighbor towards its left or towards its right in one direction only. Okay. So, he has to count himself. Let us say after second person, the third person need to be killed. So, first person is himself, second person and third person he will be killing and he will pass the gun to the next alive person. So from that person itself, he will count the third person and kills. So in this way, people will be giving the gun to the next alive person. They will start counting, they will kill and again pass on the gun. So in this way, if they want to execute or they want to kill, then tell me the place or tell me the position in which position person will be alive. So only one person will be alive. Which one is that person? There is the question. Let us try to see it with the help of an animation. Let us say A is having the gun and he is trying to kill its neighbor towards its right. A got killed and now the zeroth person will give the gun to the next alive person, that is 2. 2 is having the gun, he will try to kill immediate next, that is third person. So now third fellow is got killed and after he got killed, he will transfer the gun to the fourth fellow. And the fourth fellow will try to kill the next immediate right, which is the fifth person and he got executed now. After he got executed, the gun is now given to the next alive person, that is 0th person. Now he is having the gun. He will now try to kill the immediate next right. So the fellow is 2. The second fellow is killed. Now the 0th fellow, he will transfer the gun to the next alive fellow, that is 4th one. So the gun is now with the 4th one and towards it right immediate fellow is the 0th fellow. He is now getting killed and the 4th fellow is now alive. I hope you understood what we are going to do. Now starting at 0th point, we are trying to kill the neighbor and we are trying to find which is that person who is going to be alive. Let there are n number of person in a circle and the rth person to be killed. And we'll start counting from the person having the gun. Okay. So the recurrence relation will be having, if J, N, R we want to find, after the first execution, the number of person will become N minus 1. And again N minus 1 fellow will kill the rth fellow. As it is a circular queue, we have to do mod n operation. We will start doing this, but when we are going to stop? When only one fellow is remaining and he has to kill the rth person. Because only one fellow is remaining, he is winning. So the result is 0. So with this base condition, we will be substituting in this particular recurrence relation and try to find the result. Let us say n equal to 5, and the second fellow we are going to kill by using this particular formula. So we are going to find j of 5, 2. So to find this, we will be having n minus 1 and r. So j of 4, 2 plus 2 mod 5, because here it is 5. So in order to calculate j 4, 2, we need to calculate j 3, 2 plus 2. Here n is 4, that's why mod 4. Again, in order to find this, we have to find j of 3, 2. In order to find j of 3, 2, we have to find j of 2, 2. So j of 2, 2 plus 2 mod 3, because here n is 3. In that way, j of 2, 2 will find me j of 1, 2 plus 2 mod 2. And at last, j of 1, 2 value, we know it is 0. Now in order to solve this, what we have to do? We have to back substitute here. So after finding the value, we'll substitute it here, find the result, again substitute it here, find the result in this way. So this value we are going to substitute it here, and we'll find j of 2 comma 2 is 0 plus 2 mod 2. The value is 0. Now we got the value 0, we'll be substituting here j 2 comma 2. So j 2 comma 2 value is 0. So j 3 comma 2 becomes 0 plus 2 mod 3. So the value is 2. Now we'll substitute this value to here. So after execution of this statement, we'll be having j of 4 comma 2 equal to 2 plus 2 mod 4. This becomes 0. Now we'll substitute 0 here, and we'll find j of 5 comma 2. So j of 5 comma 2 mod 5 is 2. So it means the second fellow will be arriving in this situation. Let us see. Here n equal to 5 and r equal to 2. So now you can see the 0th fellow is having the gun. He will be killing the second person, because starting from the fellow who is having the gun, he will be killing the second person, because r equal to 2. So the first fellow got killed. Now he will be transferring the gun to the next alive fellow, 2. He will be killing the next alive fellow, that is 3. So after killing 3, he will pass the gun to the fourth fellow. And fourth fellow will be having the gun. Now he will be trying to the 0th fellow. After 0th fellow is got killed, he will transfer the gun to the next alive fellow, that is 2, and he will kill the 4th fellow. Now you can see, according to the formula also we have seen, the second fellow will be arriving, and with this example also we have seen the second fellow is arriving. Now let us check one more example. Here n equal to 4 and r equal to 2, and we are going to use this recurrence relation. J 4 comma 2 equal to j 3 comma 2 plus 2 mod 4, because here n equal to 4. Now in order to find this, again we have to find j of 2 comma 2 mod 3. So because n equal to 3 here, in order to find this, we have to find j of 1 comma 2 plus 2 mod 2, and j of 1 comma 2 is 0. Now substitute it back, we are getting here j 2 comma 2 is 0. Now this value we are going to substitute it here. J 3 comma 2 is equal to 0 plus 2 mod 3, that is equal to 2. Now substitute 2 here, we are getting J 4 comma 2 is equal to 2 plus 2 mod 3, that is 0. It means 0th fellow will be arriving. Now let us check. The 0th fellow is having the gun. He is now trying to kill the first fellow and pass the gun to the second fellow. After second fellow get the gun, he will try to kill the third fellow. Now third fellow got killed. He will pass the gun to the zeroth fellow, and zeroth fellow now will kill the second fellow. Now you can see the zeroth fellow is winning and he is now surviving. So this is what we got from this recurrence relation. So in order to write it in the form of a program, we can say Josephus integer n, integer r, two parameter will pass. If n equal to 1, will return 0. Otherwise, we'll call Josephus n minus 1, comma r plus r mod n. I hope you understood what is Josephus problem and how we are going to solve this by using recurrence relation. There are various methods of solving also. I hope you understood it. In our next video, we are going to use one more method to solve Josephus problem. So see you then. Take care. Bye.